All right, so back to the discussion. Now, my points today. Back to the delivery system to the town, any products, and in between the villages. Now, in retrospect, we're looking at meeting points being better than just, you know, village to village to village to village, to have maybe 20 close by meet up at one meeting point, and then have that one driver dash off to the next meeting point. So that cuts back on time. And so maybe we're looking at 5 hours to a major city. I'm sorry, 5 hours of meeting points, and then 4 hour drive to a major city for 400 miles. So it starts to look like, no, not 400 miles. I'm sorry, I'm not good with that, the math right now on that. But yeah, we're looking at maybe a 9 hour drive or more. So almost 24 hours for sure you could get something delivered in the city. So that's good, but only once a week, I think, because that puts too much strain on the environment of an eco-village and what it stands for. Okay, so now when we get into, where was I really talking about today? Now, the fun of this little meeting point thing, we have, let's say we have 5 meeting points, you know, about 20 villages each meet up at a central point. Now, at these meeting points, once a week, they can also be markets. So we can, you know, you don't have to all stay huddled in your Ecovillage forever and never leave. It can be market day, so we can have, you know, whoever wants to go to the market can take share rides off to the meeting point, and we can get our, you know, fresh artisan breads from maybe the village over there for our village. And conversely, we give off artichokes, or we give out, you know, whatever we have. But so it becomes like fill up your basket day, but it's something that you don't have to pay for. It's something that, you know, we paid for already from the, you know, our work efforts in the fields of producing the items. So it's just like collection. We get our collection, we get our bounty, and we get all of our different assortments. So we have a good supply of food. You know, so we have different breads, we can have different muffin ladies, whatever. All of these things that just show up, and you'll be like, oh my goodness, you know, and be like, great, and or gems, whatever people make. So it is kind of pilgrimy. It is kind of, what is the other terminology, a Mormon. But it's something that is yet fresh. It's a fresh statement on all of that. Because you don't have to be any of those things. You don't have to be a pilgrim. You don't have to be a Mormon. You just have to adhere to not really wanting to be on the money chain as your controller, and using it only as using those little money droplets to just make sure that we can exist and survive comfortably. As comfortable as possible in this here society, in this group where the extremes on the other side, you know, out over there on the roadways driving past are absolutely, they've flipped their cookies, and you know it. They have gone into greed, fanaticism. And so this whole deal, this 100 village thing, is not about greed, fanaticism at all. It's just a step back and go, whoa, that's just not anything I want anything to do with. So now we're dealing with water, obviously, being the major issue of everything. Because, I mean, you can always get the solar panels. You can always have some kind of electricity. You know, I want at least three, and I say three because I don't think there are that many of you, 3 innovator villages. Now, the innovator villages will be for things like creating different energy sources and blah 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 that will be helpful for the other villages also. So they'll be like, well, because we can make these hot tubs environments, you know, where you go to the center place, and then there's the hot tub, and then it's wood heated or whatever, and so we have constant hot water. We can take a bath that way. But and when you look back at everything, you're like, no, you're going to take the forest down eventually. So we have to have a backup. We have a backup system for that, like immediately. As wonderful as it is to have that cooked hot tub event, and you're like, oh, great, I just, you know, that's the way to bathe. We're clean quickly, and water is saved. There's a point where you actually have to go, well, you know, we have to heat it another way. And then, so it becomes a lot about water storage. It's just going to be like, we need an entire village where we just discuss this, and that's what we do, and we make all kinds of different methodologies and find out what's the best. So we need energy. We need three villages that are really, really keen on innovation, but yet at a very, very low cost, costs that are not hurtful. Okay, to anybody's budget, because we don't really have a budget. These are the 5,000, I'm talking 5,000 entry into this community and forever. You don't ever have to pay again. So these are really, really, really situations where we survive comfortably in this world with off-grid without the influx. The influx of demanding income and demanding companies, blah, 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 that want to persist their egos and control factors on us. Okay, so yeah, so it's really about being completely independent. And I don't know, I guess, you know, I'm not a complete expert on it, but I am in a way. I mean, you can go many, many weeks without taking a bath. We're talking about building these cob houses. Now, not taking a bath is going to be a bummer. You're just, you know, all the time in mud. I don't think that's so cool. So we're going to have some kind of an alternative water source that really we can clean ourselves off ever so often. Because that's the thing of it. We'll just be mud kids, real old mud kids. So that's not so great. But anyway, so that was the coolness of today, was the market, having that moment where we can swap items that are food prepared, within at least 20 villages at a time. And I think that will suffice. I think that each one then will get well-rounded diets. You know, if we can't just grow garlic at all, maybe one is just we're terrible at growing garlic. We just can't do it. We're just stupid when it comes to garlic. Well, then okay. Then all right. Maybe somebody else has that garlic for you. So all of those things come into fruition. And anyway, so I added also 5 teepee demand, 5 teepee demand to village demand. So there will be 5 villages that are teepees only, because I just think that even if people don't want to stay there their whole entire life, people from the cob village communities will want to be there, because I believe that environment, the teepee environment, it brings something new to you as a human being, something more essential, something even closer to nature. You don't have to have water at every facility. You can always go and pick up your water and then, you know, drag it back with a big, a case or whatever, one of those water things. And gosh dang it, I threw a whole bunch of my water. I had a whole bunch of those water vessels. My mom, she saved like 20 of them, and I just threw them out at the recyclery, because I just felt like I was falling through the cracks and nobody was out here, and nobody, you know, cares. But they would have been perfect. But yeah, those plastic water jugs, those are great. If we can figure out a way to haul those back and forth to each little house, each little teepee, zone. And so the teepee zone will have planks, and I'm really loving those, and they can have little fires inside. Yeah, I don't want to do the briquette, charcoal briquette fire starter. And no, I didn't really want that. I believe we can make natural fire starters. That would be better, more ideal. But I do like the, if the teepee is big enough, you can have the fire in it. So we're and also gates. I need to talk about gate system. How gated are we going to become? How gated are we going to be? The gates are going to be very pricey. Very pricey. Anything that opens and closes made of steel is pricey. And then fencing. Fencing is also pricey. If you look at barbed wire, it isn't. If you look at the terrible electric line fence, it isn't. So we can put the scare tactic electric line fencing all around the facility. You can put the crop zone all around the houses. So that gives us a buffer zone away from other people. Okay, I understand some of you villages will want to be nudist villages, and that's okay. But that's just going to be for the people who want to sign up for those ones. They want to sign up for the nudist villages, and they go, "Ooh." Yeah, and that's your deal. But that's the type of thing, you know, some type of fencing, and then especially in those ones, you need some kind of, you put your crops actually around where the houses are. Okay. So, and then keep all of the rigmaroles out. Okay, so when we're blocking off that road, we're blocking off the roadway itself, because we don't want strangers there. We just don't want strangers at any of these villages. I do not believe that these are going to be places we want population visits. If you want to sell your little anti-maize apple cider or applesauce out there at a market, you're going to have to go out there at a market. I don't actually want strangers showing up in these villages. I don't trust people anymore. There's just too many wackos out there. I don't want strangers knowing where we live. I don't want big advertising signs. This is the Happy Yappies. I don't want any mean human beings getting bees in their bonnets that they're going to go and get the Happy Yappies. You understand? I want us to be safe. That means we have to be secluded. So we have to be back off of the roads. In many places, you start going deeper and deeper into California. Okay. So yeah, and then we may need some kind of gated fence with intercom systems. And I'll try not to be such a meanie. Anyway. rubber band, if you're singing, you need a rubber band voice. That's what Andrea Scholl was saying. Remember, you're a rubber band. Yeah.